A rockstar welcome for a man once dubbed the rockstar politician. It's been 7 years since President Obama first addressed Congress. This was his last.
And for this final one, I'm going to try to make it a little shorter.
There were no big announcements. This was a defense of President Obama's policies and of the America he's governed. An inclusive America, one which doesn't tolerate anti-Muslim rhetoric. It was a swipe at Donald Trump without actually naming him.
When politicians insult Muslims, whether abroad or our fellow citizens, when a mosque is vandalized, or a kid is called names, that doesn't make us safer. That's not telling it like it is. It's just wrong. It diminishes us in the eyes of the world. It makes it harder to achieve our goals. It betrays who we are as a country.
A country which is still the strongest in the world, he said. One which can defeat a range of threats from IS to cancer.
For the loved ones we've all lost, for the families that we can still save, let's make America the country that cures cancer once and for all.
As the First Lady looked on, there was an empty seat next to her, a poignant tribute to victims of gun violence. Gun control's just one issue the president's failed to get this room of politicians to agree with him on.
It's one of the few regrets of my presidency that the rancor and suspicion between the parties has gotten worse instead of better. I have no doubt a president with the gifts of Lincoln or Roosevelt might have better bridged the divide. And I guarantee I'll keep trying to be better so long as I hold this office.
This State of the Union's been a chance for President Obama to highlight what he's done in office and for his critics to point out what he hasn't. In just over a year's time, there'll be a new president at the White House and a newly elected Congress. So for President Obama, the months ahead are key in determining how he goes down in history. Regini Vaidyanathan, BBC News, Washington.